Two or three years old.
وفي وسط الاحتفال والناس محتفلة خالص مبسوطة.
As the people are celebrating and really happy and having fun.
وبعد كده خلاص قرب يخلص الحفلة يعني في نهاية الحفلة.
Now they're getting ready to wrap up.
بيدوروا على البيبي اللي هيحتفلوا بيه.
They were looking for the baby they're celebrating.
مش موجود.
And the baby's not even there.
كلهم كانوا مشغولين بإيه؟ بالاحتفال مش كده؟
Everyone was so preoccupied with the celebration itself.
والبيبي مات ما عرفش حصلت accident كده فده قصة حقيقية يعني ومات.
It's a true story and the baby actually died in that birthday party.
هم عمالين يحتفلوا في party في احتفال.
And so here there's a big party celebration.
بطفل.
About a baby.
محدش مهتم بيه.
That no one is giving the attention to this baby.
لكن مهتمين بالاحتفال نفسه.
But their attention is of the actual celebration.
الفستان بتاعي أحلى فستان ولا يعني موضة يعني كده يعني ولا.
My dress the best is the best fashionable dress.
حد شافه قبل كده ولا أول مرة يظهر في الوجود يعني كده يعني.
Have you ever seen this or is this like the first time you've ever seen this?
حفلة اللي احنا فيها دي الأكل فيها أحلى أكل ولا كده يعني.
Was the food the best food or what?
والزينة اللي اتعملت يعني ما حصلتش قبل كده.
And the decorations, I mean, wow.
هو كل ده اهتمام الناس بعيد الميلاد عبارة عن مظاهر الاحتفال.
See, that's the focus of people in Christmas. They just look at the outward looks of things.
لكن عيد الميلاد أعمق بكتير. هو احتفال بالمولود بيسوع.
But Christmas is much deeper than that. It's a celebration of a person, the one born Jesus.
What
made this a different birthday than any other birth?
لدرجة إن السماء أعلنت إن ده شخص مولود مختلف عن أي واحد اتولد قبل كده.
To the point that heaven declares that this person born is different than anyone ever born.
ما سمعناش عن السماء تنزل جيش من الملائكة يرنموا لواحد اتولد. ما سمعناش.
Never heard of heaven bringing down a host of angels to sing for just one baby.
ما سمعناش عن نجم ظهر نجم كده ملوش مثال ملوش مثيل ظهر. يكون نجم متميز اسمه نجمه نجم المسيح.
And you've never heard ever of a specific star that is unique that it's called it's his star ever appearing for anybody else.
ما سمعناش عن ملك يتخض ويترعب من مولود صغير طفل ويقتل كل عيل سنه أكتر من سنة أقل من سنتين.
We've never heard about a king who's terrified and is troubled by a baby born and kills every child 2 years and below.
هو ايه الجديد في المولود ده?
What is new in this baby?
حاجة جديدة.
He's something
حاجة
different.
عظيمة.
Something new. Something
حاجة
great.
حاجة محدش سمع عنها قبل كده.
Something no one heard about before.
لكن ذكرت في الكتاب.
But is mentioned in the Bible.
وأعلنت.
And has been revealed.
أنها العذراء تحبل وتلد ابناً. ابن متميز.
Behold, the virgin will conceive, and he's going to be special.
هو ليه ربنا معرفش يلاقي طريقة تاني غير إن هو يجي في صورة بيبي يعني ليه يعني؟
I mean, why did God come in the form of a baby anyways? Couldn't he find a different way?
حد ممكن سأل السؤال ده يعني هو ربنا مش قادر ان هو يخلص شعبه بدون ما ان هو ينزل ويبقى بيبي صغير.
I mean, couldn't God just save his people without having to go through all this and come and be a baby for?
وليه المهانة دي?
I mean, why all this trouble?
ليه ربنا يتولد في مزود صغير? ليه يعني?
And it's so shameful. Why would God be born in a manger?
عارفين يعني مزود يعني?
Because you know what a manger is?
أسوأ مكان يعني في الدنيا.
It's the worst place in the planet, really.
مزبلة يعني. ما مش عارف إذا أقولها إيه بالعربي. يعني مكان اللي ما تقدرش تشم فيه هواء كده.
It's disgusting. It's the air. You can't just breathe in there. It's really smells bad.
وليه ربنا بيعمل كده؟
Why would God do this?
ليه ربنا بيختار كده؟
Why would God choose this?
وبعد كده يموت يعني. ده حكاية دي حكاية غريبة الأصل يعني ربنا يموت على الصليب هو ليه اللي بيحصل ده ليه كده يعني
And then after that die God dies on the cross I mean why
ربنا مش قادر بكلمة يخلص ويعمل
I mean can't God just save with like a word
كل هذه أسئلة ممكن احنا بنفكر فيها ويمكن حد تاني يسألنا فيها ليه
These are all questions that we sometimes think about or others ask us about it why
حد عنده إجابة؟
Any answers out there?
النهاردة عايزين نحكي مش عن قصة لكن عن حدث وعن خطة الله لخلاص البشر.
See, today we don't want to discuss not a story but an incident that happened about the story of salvation.
الله القدير العالي.
God Almighty.
بالنسبة لناس كتير بيقول عنه إله مجهول مش عارفينه هو شكله إيه.
Many people consider him the unknown God. They don't know what he looks like.
وفي ناس لغاية دلوقتي مش عارفين هو مين الإله اللي بيعبدوه هو شكله إيه منظره إيه.
And many people till today they don't know what their God looks like.
ويمكن أنت بتفكر هو ربنا شكله إيه منظره إيه طبيعته إيه أنا ما عرفش أنا بصلي كده مثلا الهوى وهو مين ربنا ده
And maybe you're thinking this you know what does God look like what's his nature like what am I praying to am I praying to the air what does he look like
وبالنسبة لشعب الله
And to God's people
الله ده إله مخيف
God is scary he's fearful
فاكرين المنظر اللي ربنا ظهر للشعب لما عطالهم الوصايا عطالهم الشريعة
Do you guys remember how God in the way that he appeared when he came and gave the commandment
حد فاكر المنظر
Does anyone remember what the image looked like
احنا ذكرنا الموضوع ده في المؤتمر اللي فات
We talked about it in the last retreat
حد يقول لي هو المؤتمر انا فاكر الاسبوع اللي فات الخدمة عشان بس anyway
Some will say are you kidding I don't even remember last week's message
Anyway, المنظر الرهيب اللي على جبل سيناء الجبل اللي كان بيدخن نار بيدخن
So that image in Mount Sinai, the smoke that was coming out of there.
والرعد والصوت السماء اللي يرعب الناس.
And the thundering and the voice from heaven that's scary.
هو ده منظر الله للناس لشعب الله عن الله.
See, that's the way, the image that God's people view God sometimes.
ناس لما شافوا ربنا بالمنظر ده قالوا احنا مش عايزين نتعامل مع ربنا احنا خايفين.
When they saw God in that way, they said, we don't want to deal with him, we're scared.
قالوا يا موسى انت تعامل مع ربنا.
They said, hey Moses, you deal with God.
وانت تقول لنا ربنا عايز يقول ايه.
And you tell us what God wants to say.
لكن احنا نيجي لقدام ربنا وربنا يكلمنا لا ده مخيف ربنا ده مخيف.
But we come before God and God speaks to us, that's scary.
ربنا عطاهم الوصايا.
God gave them the commandments.
عطاهم الشريعة.
He gave them the commandment.
اللي يصنع الشريعة هيحيا.
And whoever does it will live.
لكن اللي ما يعملش الشريعة يخطئ في أي واحدة من الشريعة من الوصايا يموت. هو ده.
Whoever doesn't do any of the commandments dies.
هو ده منظر ربنا.
That's the image that God has portrayed.
اللي الناس عرفوا ربنا بيها.
That people knew God by.
بالنسبة للشعب الله اللي هو في الشريعة عرف ربنا إن هو إله قاسي.
So to the people of Israel in the Old Testament, they know God as He is a harsh God.
وبالنسبة لليونانيين وبالنسبة للأمم الناس اللي بعيد عن شعب الله إله مجهول ما يعرفوهوش.
And to the Greeks and the Gentiles, to them. God is unknown. He's far. They
لكن
don't
ما زال الشوق في قلب الإنسان إن هو يعرف ربنا عايز يعرف ربنا.
But there's still a desire in the heart of man to know God.
في احتياج جوه إن الواحد يعبد الله.
There's this need inside to worship God.
أنا أعرف ناس ممكن يكونوا يعني بعيد خالص عن ربنا لكن في جوه قلبهم لازم يعبدوا حاجة.
I know some people that are very far from God, but in their heart they feel like they gotta worship something.
عشان كده الناس بتروح تعبد المخدرات، تعبد حاجات تاني غير ربنا، لان في احتياج لجوه ان انا اكون حاجه يعني اكون انا مستعبد ليها يعني.
And that's why people worship different things like drugs, and people feel like they need to be under influence or controlled by something.
فالمنظر بالنسبه قبل مجيء الرب كان الموضوع بالنسبه ان صوره الله يا اما اله مجهول يا اما اله مرعب للناس.
And so the image of God before Jesus came was either he's an unknown God or he's a scary God.
مكتوب لأن الناموس بموسى أعطي.
It's written that the law was given by Moses.
وأن أجرة الخطية هي موت.
And the wages of sin is death.
ولو ما عملتش الوصية اللي ربنا بيقول لك عليها أنت هتموت.
And if you don't do the commandment that God tells you, you will die.
ولازم تقدم ذبيحه لو اخطات، كل مره تعمل خطيه لازم تذبح ذبيحه علشان ربنا يرضى عليك.
And every time you sin you have to offer sacrifice so that God will be pleased with you.
الله كان بعيد.
God was far.
بالنسبه للانسان.
To man.
الانسان ما كانش عارف يوصل لربنا.
Man couldn't reach God.
ربنا واقف وبيحب الانسان.
And God is there and he's standing and he loves
man. طبيعته حب للانسان.
His nature is love for man.
وشايف الانسان بيبتعد عنه لانه مش عارفه.
And he sees man getting further away from him because man doesn't know him.
والله جواه كميه حب غير عاديه مش قادر يوضحها للناس اللي هي بتبتعد عنه وفاكره ان ربنا دوا مخيف مرعب هيذبحهم هيموتهم.
And God has amazing love that he wants to give to people, and the people keep going far from him because they're afraid and terrified.
لغاية دلوقتي في الكنيسة في ناس يمكن حضر الكنيسة وهي بعيد عن ربنا لأنها ما زالت مش قادرة تقرب من ربنا، خايفة منه، فاكرة إن الخطية اللي جواها ربنا واقف وكده بالوحدة عايز يموتك على الخطية اللي انت بتعملها.
And until today, there's people still coming to church and attend and can't get close to God because they're afraid of him, because they feel that God is standing there on every sin waiting to punish.
الله مش كده.
And God's not like that.
الله طبيعته محبة. الله محبة.
God's nature is he is love.
علشان كده الكتاب بيقول الله بينا يعني أظهر كل القلب. الله بين محبته لنا وإذ نحن بعد خطاة بعدين مات المسيح من أجل.
That's why the Bible says God demonstrated, he showed his love for us as we were yet sinners, he sent Jesus to die for us.
هي دي قصة الميلاد.
That's the story of Christmas.
هي قصة نعمة.
It's a story of grace.
يعني الله بين محبته لناس ما يستحقوش خطاط عارفهم عارف ان هم خطأ عصوا بعدوا.
God demonstrates his love, showed his love to people who are sinners, who are far, who are just very far from him.
هي دي قصة الميلاد ليا وليك النهارده.
That's the story of Christmas to you and me today.
مش مجرد قصة احداث لكن قصة حب الله لشعبه.
It's not just a story of chronological order of incidents that happened, but it's a story of God's love for his people.
قصة نعمة.
Story of grace.
بيقول أما أن لأن الناموس بموسى أعطي أما ده حاجة مختلفة أما النعمة والحق فبيسوع المسيح صارا.
Just like it says that the law was given through Moses, but grace has come through Jesus Christ.
النهاردة لو كنت مش فاهم ربنا كويس النهاردة ربنا في عيد الميلاد عايز يقول لك أنا جيت لأجل إني بحبك.
And so if you don't understand God today, he wants to tell you in the Christmas time, he said, I came because I love you.
أنا جيت علشان أوري لك نفسي لأنك مش فاهمني.
I came so I can declare myself to you because you don't understand me.
كتاب بيقول الله لم يره أحد قط.
The Bible says no one has ever seen God.
موسى ما قدرش يشوف ربنا.
Moses couldn't see God.
مع إنه قال أرني مجدك.
Even though he said, "Show me your
glory." قال له ما فيش حد يشوفني ويحيا هيموت يعني.
He said, "No one can see me and live; you'll die."
لكن الكتاب بيقول الله لم يره أحد، لكن الابن الوحيد الذي هو في حضن الآب هو خبر.
And the Bible says that God, no one has seen him, but the only begotten Son, he is the one that came and declared.
يعني ابن الله المسيح جه على الأرض علشان يعلن محبة الله الآب لينا.
And so the Son of God, Jesus Christ, he came to declare the love of God the Father to us.
هكذا هكذا أحب الله العالم حتى بذل ابنه الوحيد.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son.
إيه السبب؟
What for?
إيه السبب إن ربنا يبذل ابنه الوحيد في الأرض هنا؟
What's the reason for God to give his Son here on earth?
لكي لا يهلك كل من يؤمن به بل تكون له الحياة الأبدية.
So that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life.
ربنا مش عايزك تهلك.
God doesn't want you to perish.
ربنا مش في قلبه انه يهلك الانسان اللي خلقه.
It is not in God's heart to have man whom he created to perish.
الله خلقني وخلقك لان بيحبنا عايز لذتي في بني ادم.
God created you and created me because he loves us and he said my joy is in
the sons of Adam. طبيعة الله لينا هي الحب.
God's nature for us is love.
لم يأتي كي يديننا لم يأتي كي يلوم بل جاء لفداءنا وأنقذ المظلوم.
He did not come to judge us but he came to redeem us and to save those who are oppressed.
هي ده مجيء المسيح لينا على الأرض.
That's the coming of Christ on
earth. لم يأتي ليديننا.
He didn't come to judge.
هو قال كده أنا جيت.
He said this.
المسيح نفسه لما جه على الأرض. Christ. أنا جيت لكي تكون لكم حياة مش أي حياة لكن يكون لنا أفضل حياة.
He said that I came here not that you just have life but that you may have better life.
ما قالش أنا جاي عشان أموتك.
He didn't say I'm coming to kill you.
ده جاي علشان يموت علشانك.
He came to die for you.
هل عرفت محبة ربنا؟
Do you know the love of God?
هل شفتها؟ هل اختبرتها؟
Have you experienced it? Have you seen it?
لسه عايش بعيد عنه لأنك خايف منه.
Are you still living far from him because you're afraid of him?
أو لسه ما عرفتوش لأن ما تعرفش مين ربنا ده.
Or do you still not know him because you don't know who God is?
النهاردة ربنا عايز يقول لك أنا بحبك.
Today God wants to tell you I love you.
أنا جاي علشان أنتشلك من الموت من الهلاك بسبب الخطية اللي أنت عايش فيها.
I've come to save you from death from perishing because of the sin that you're living in.
وده اختيارك.
And that's your decision.
أنا هعمل كل حاجة علشان أبين محبتي ليك.
I will do everything to show you my love.
الله بين محبته لنا.
God demonstrates his own love for us.
مش علشان نستحق مش علشان احنا كويسين.
Not because we're worthy or because we're good.
لا ده هو عارفني وعارفك صدقني عارفنا كويس او عارف قبلتنا وعارف الخطيه اللي احنا اللي جوانا عارف الخطا.
Yeah, he knows you and he knows me and he knows us really well. He knows what we're made of.
لكن الله بين محبته واذ نحن بعد خطاه مات المسيح عشان كده مات.
But God demonstrates his own love toward us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
يبقى أول سبب إن ربنا ليجه على الأرض بتاعنا علشان يبين صفة محبته لينا.
So first reason for why did God come to earth is to show, to demonstrate his love for us.
جه قريب قوي لينا.
He came really close to us.
وجه ومش جه وبس لكن جه لأوحش مكان ممكن الإنسان يتخيله جه للمزود.
And he didn't just come, he came to the worst place that anyone could imagine in a manger.
علشان يحوله ويغيره ويبقى أحلى مكان كل العالم تبص عليه.
So that he can turn it and that it would be the best place for the world to look at.
لو كنت عايش في أوحش حتة.
If you're living in the worst place.
أو كنت عايش أوحش حياة.
Or maybe you're living the worst life.
حتى ما تتشمش عارف يعني زي المزود كده بالضبط.
And so something that stinks so bad like the manger, maybe that's how your life feels.
ربنا جه صدقني ربنا جه للمكان ده اللي انت موجود فيه علشان يغيره.
I promise you God came to this specific place that you're in so he could change it.
ما تقولش المكان اللي انا عايش فيه او اللي موجود فيه او اللي بحيا فيه ده ربنا مستحيل ان هو يوصل ويغير. ربنا يقدر يوصل لحياتك مهما كان شرك وبعدك عنه. هو جه للمزود.
Don't feel that you're in a place that God can't touch or change. He came that he could change your life no matter how bad or how much sin you've done.
ربنا جه علشان يبين محبة الآب لينا.
God came to show the love of the Father for us.
مش بس كده.
Not just that.
لكن ربنا جه علشان يقول لك أنا قريب ليك.
God came to say I'm close to you.
أصلي لو واحد بعيد عنك خالص مش فاهمك مش كده ما يفهمكش.
If someone is really far from you, they don't understand you, right?
لكن اللي قريب ليك.
But the one who's close to you.
اللي عاش في نفس الحتة بتاعتك.
The one who lived in the same area you're living.
يفهمك.
They can understand you.
ويقدر يفهم احتياجاتك.
And they can understand your needs.
ورب جه علشان يبقى قريب جدا لكل احتياج فينا ولكل ألم جوانا علشان يقول لك أنا اختبرت وعرفت كل حاجة.
And so God came to say that he knows every need we have and he has experienced everything to say he can understand.
هو عمانوئيل الله مش ضدي الله معنا.
He's Emmanuel, not God against me, but God with us.
هو ده اسمه.
That's his name.
هي دي طبيعته.
That's his nature.
النهاردة رب عايز يقولك أنا مش بعيد عنك ولا عن مشاكلك.
Today God wants to say I'm not far from you or far from your problems.
لكن سبب ان انا انزل عشان اقول لك انا مش بعيد عنك انا قريب منك.
But the reason that I came is to tell you I'm not far from you I'm near you.
بيقول في سفر العبرانيين من ثم كان ينبغي ان يشبه اخواته في كل شيء. عبرانيين 2:17.
And in Hebrews 2:17 he says that therefore in all things he had to be made like his brethren.
لكي يكون رحيماً.
That he might be a merciful.
ورئيس كهنة أمين.
And faithful high priest.
لأن فيما هو قد تألم مجرباً يقدر أن يعين المجربين.
For in that he himself has suffered being tempted, he is able to aid those who are tempted.
إيه رأيك النهاردة؟ تتمتع بالإله اللي هو رحيم. هو دي طبعته.
Today. Do you want to enjoy the God who is merciful and that's his nature? Emmanuel.
ربنا مش ضدك.
God is not against you.
ربنا عايز سعادتك.
God wants your happiness.
لما بيقول لك تعالى إلي.
When he says come to me.
بيقول لك مش تعالى معايا عشان أعذبك.
He doesn't say come to me so I can torture you.
بيقول لك تعالى إلي يا جميع المتعبين والثقيل الأحمال وأنا أريحكم. هو عارف راحة قلبك فين.
He says come to me all you who labor and are with heavy burdens and I will give you rest. He knows where your rest is.
ياللي بعيد عن ربنا النهارده حتى لو كنت جوه الكنيسه ومش فاهم ربنا كويس النهارده الرب بيقول لك تعالى لي انت متعذب بعيد عني.
God says even if you're in church God says come to me you're tortured when you're far from me come to me so I can give you rest.
انت بتعذب نفسك.
Why are you torturing yourself?
انا عارف راحتك.
I know what's good for you and what gives you rest.
تعالوا الي.
Come to me.
تعالوا الي.
Come to me.
بلاش تبتعد عني.
Stop going far from me.
أنا جيت من السماء للأرض هنا علشان أكون قريب منك.
I came from heaven to earth so that I could be near you.
عشان أكون معاك.
So I could be with you.
الله معنا.
God with us.
اختبر كل حاجة زينا ما عدا الخطأ.
He experienced everything like us except sin.
اختبر الجوع.
He experienced hunger.
البرد.
Cold.
الرفض.
Rejection.
الألم.
Pain.
اختبر كل شيء.
He experienced everything.
وهو يعلم.
And he knows.
ويقدر. أن يعين المجربين نظيره.
And is able to help those who are tested.
لو عايز لو عايز كونسلينج
if you want counseling
انا مش ضد السايكولوجيست
I'm not against psychologists
انا عارف ان في سايكولوجيست وسطينا يعني
I know there's some psychologists in our midst
انا بخاف اتكلم معاهم
I'm scared to talk with them.
أول ما بتكلم مع واحد psychologist.
Right when you talk with a psychologist.
أشوف عينيه عمال ماشي يعني كده بيفكر.
You see that their eyes are moving all over the place.
عمال يفحصني من جوه ومن برا.
Testing me inside and outside. How am I talking?
How is my facial expression? How is my hands going? كل حاجة عندهم ليها درجات يعني تعرف كده يقول لا ده هو nervous كده مش عارف لأنه بيحرك إيديكتي وهو بيتكلم مش عارف ده إيه لأنه كل حاجة عندهم. وفي الاخر يقيمك ويسيبك يسيبك زي ما انت كده اوحش يعني يطلعك يقول لك انت صباح الخير
so they have a grading system for everything and then in the end they give you they tell you what your state is and you walk out worse because now you know what you are and you feel worse
احلى حاجه عملها السايكولوجيست هو واحد من السايكولوجيست بيشنت عندي فيقول لي احنا اللي بنعمله ان احنا نقعد نحط رجل على رجل ونسمع بس
so I know the psychologist that he says best thing you know all I do is I just cross my legs and listen
يحطه في حته كده بعيده ويقول اتكلم انا هسمعك
and then they just tell the person just speak and I'm just gonna listen
لا ربنا مش كده
that's not how God is
ربنا مش بس بيسمعك
God doesn't just hear you
لكن يقدر ان يعين
but he's able to help
يعين
he's able to help
تعال له النهارده لانه هو قريب وصل لنا وصل 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 لكل حاجه احنا وصلنا اليها
come to him because he is near he has gone through everything we have
يبقى اول حاجه جه علشان يتواصل معنا ثاني حاجه جه علشان يبقى قريب من طبيعتنا
so first thing is he came to demonstrate his love second is he came to be close to us and experience what we've experienced
لكن ثالث حاجه
but the third thing
ان كان بين الله وبين الانسان كان في عداوه
The third thing is that there was this enmity between God and man.
مش من الله الله ما عندوش عداوة للإنسان.
It is not from God's perspective. He doesn't have enmity toward man.
لكن الإنسان بعد وبقي عدو لله.
But man went far and became enemy with God.
لأن الخطية فصلت بين الإنسان والله.
Because sin has separated between man and God.
آدم راح اختبأ وقال ما مش عايز أسمع صوت ربنا أنا خايف.
Adam went and hid. He says, "I don't want to hear God's voice."
ربنا قعد يدور عليه أين فينك يا آدم؟ آدم اختفى بعيد عن ربنا لأنه شعر إنه ربنا يعني لأنه أخطأ.
God said, "Where are you, Adam?" And Adam hid because he knew he sinned.
خطية فصلت بين الإنسان وبين الله.
Sin separated between God and man.
لدرجة إن أيوب ده أقدم سفر في العهد القديم.
To the point that Job, which is the oldest book in the Old Testament,
صرخ في مرة.
Cried out once.
وليس بيننا أي بين الإنسان والله ليس بيننا مصالح.
And he said, "There's no one to reconcile between us."
يضع يده على كلينا واحد كده يوصل نحن الاثنين ويحط إيده بين الإنسان وبين الله ويصلحنا مع بعض. ما فيش.
There's no one to reconcile between God and man. No one can put his hand on both and reconcile the two of us.
فاهمين معايا؟
يعني
واحد مصالح يبقى إيه؟ يوصل لربنا.
So one who could reconcile should be able to reach
يبقى زي
God.
ربنا كده.
Be like God.
عشان توصل لربنا لازم تبقى زيه.
To reach God, you have to be like God.
ويبقى مع الإنسان يبقى إنسان يعرف يوصل للإنسان ويبقى زي إنسان.
And to reach man, you have to be like man.
ويحط إيده على ربنا ويحط إيده على الإنسان ويصلحهم مع بعض.
And you put your hand on God, you put your hand on man, and you reconcile them.
هل في ممكن تحصل ان يبقى في مصالح يصالح الانسان مع الله
Can there ever be one who reconciles like that?
ايوه يكون مين ممكن يبقى مصالح
What do you think who can do that? Who can do it?
هل ممكن ملاك يعمل الموضوع ده؟
Can an angel do that?
هل الملاك يوصل لربنا؟
Can an angel touch God?
ده الملائكة دي عبارة عن عبيد لله يعني
You know angels are nothing more but the servants.
فهم تحت ربنا
So they're below God.
وفوق الإنسان هم فين دول فوق الإنسان طبعا فوقينا.
And they are above man.
ما يقدروش يعملوا كده.
They can't do that.
طب مين ممكن يعمل المصالحة دي بين الإنسان والله؟
So who can reconcile between man and God?
كانش ينفع حد.
No one else could.
غير ابن الله يسوع اللي ينزل.
Except the Son of God, Jesus, who comes down.
الكلمة صار جسدا.
The word became flesh.
وحل بيننا.
And has come among us.
خدين بالكم.
Guys, notice.
يعني ابن الله ده مساوي لله مش كده؟
So the Son of God, he's equal with God, right?
ده يقدر يتصالح لأنه في مصالح.
He can reconcile because he is equal with God, right?
وفي نفس الوقت لازم يبقى إنسان.
But at the same time, he has to be man.
والكلمة صار جسدا.
And the Word became flesh.
وحل بيننا.
And has come among us.
هو ده الميلاد.
That's Christmas.
إن الله ظهر في الجسد.
That God came in the flesh.
ملء الزمان أرسل الله ابنه مولود من امرأة مولود تحت الناموس.
In the fullness of time, God sent His Son, born of a woman, born under the law.
صار إنسان.
Became man.
كتاب بيقول كده إن مفيش إله. مفيش وسيط بين الله والناس إلا يسوع الإنسان يسوع المسيح.
The Bible says that there's only one God and one mediator between God and man, and that is the man Jesus Christ.
حاجة ما تتصدقش مش كده بالعقل.
You can't believe this just by your mind. It's hard to conceptualize.
إزاي الله يبقى إنسان؟
How can God be man?
إزاي الله ياخد صورة إنسان؟
How can God take the image of man?
لكن الله يستطيع كل شيء.
But God can do everything, right?
هو اللي خلق الإنسان، هو اللي ممكن يبقى إنسان.
He created man, he can be man.
في حاجات مستحيل إن أنت تفهمها بعقلك.
There are things that are impossible to understand with
the mind. لأن أعمال الله أعلى كتير من مخنا.
Because the works of God are way bigger, way higher than our thought can fathom.
عشان كده في حاجات بالذات موضوع الميلاد والتجسد.
And so there's some things that are difficult, especially the incarnation of Christ. It's a secret.
بيقول الكتاب عظيم هو سر التقوى. الله ظهر في الجسد.
The Bible says great is the mystery of godliness. God came in the flesh.
هل الله لما تولد بقي في تولد هل كان في خطيه
when Christ was born was there sin
طبعا لا لانه لم يولد باجساد وباحشاء مريم او باحشاء يوسف او باحشاء الجسد لكن الروح نفسه حل على مريم العذراء.
So of course not. There's no sin in him because he was the Holy Spirit who came upon Mary.
حصلت المعجزة.
The miracle happened.
اتحد اللاهوت بالناسوت.
And so there's been unity between God and man.
في يسوع.
In Jesus Christ.
يعني يسوع كان بالجسد إنسان.
So Jesus in the flesh was man, had humanity.
لكن اللاهوت لم يفارق الناسوت.
But when he was human on earth, as a human, the deity never left his humanity.
بيقول الكتاب إن كل ملء اللاهوت كان في المسيح.
The Bible says that all the fullness of God was in Christ.
فهذا الميلاد هو ميلاد عجيب.
This birth of Christ is amazing.
لأنه ميلاد.
Because it's the birth.
المسيح.
Of Christ.
بالجسد أخذ صورة جسد لكن هو كان في ملء اللاهوت.
And he took the image in the flesh, but he was also fully God.
علشان كده الإعلان الإلهي لما جه المسيح يتعمد على يد يوحنا المعمدان.
And that's why the declaration when Jesus came to be baptized at the hands of John the Baptist.
حصلت هزة في السماء.
There was a shaking that happened in heaven.
لأن هو بلا خطية مش كده؟
He's without sin, right?
يوحنا المعمدان لما جه كان بيعمد كان بيعمدهم معمودية الماء اللي هي علشان يتغسلوا من من الخطية.
And so you know John's baptism was a baptism of water, right?
فالسماء أعلنت هذا الإعلان.
And so heaven declared this declaration.
ربنا تكلم من السماء الله.
God the Father spoke from heaven.
مرتين.
Twice.
على المسيح وهو على الأرض.
About Christ when Christ was on earth.
في المعمودية.
Once in the baptism.
شاور عليه.
He pointed at him.
هذا هو ابن الحبيب الذي به سررت.
And said, "This is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased."
هو عنده كم ابن؟
How many sons does he have?
واحد. هذا ابني الحبيب الذي به سررت.
This is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased.
الروح القدس حل عليه كحمامة.
The Holy Spirit came upon him in an image of a dove.
لأول مرة.
And for the first time.
يلتقوا الله الآب والله الابن والروح القدس واحد.
And for the first time on earth, you see the meeting of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit in the time of the baptism of Jesus.
مرة تانية في التجلي.
The other time is in the Mount of Transfiguration.
لما ابتدوا بقى انبسطوا قوي بالمنظر وهم على جبل التجلي ورب يسوع مع إيليا وموسى منظر عجيب فالتلاميذ بقى الثلاث تلاميذ اللي أخذهم المسيح انبسطوا قوي وقالوا خلينا نقعد هنا على طول.
And so in the Mount of Transfiguration, the three disciples were so excited when they saw Jesus and they saw Elijah and Moses, and they said, "Let's just stay here forever."
نصنع يعني خيام كده واحدة لموسى واحدة لإيليا واحدة للمسيح.
Let's make some tents, one for Christ, one for Moses, one for Elijah.
وعلى طول جه الصوت من السماء.
And right away, a voice came from heaven.
لا لا ما ينفعش. المسيح ده غير إيليا غير موسى. أصل هو مش نبي جاي. لا ده مختلف.
He says, "No, no, you can't do that. See, Christ is different than Elijah, than Moses. He's not a prophet like them. He's different." And then we hear a voice from heaven again.
هذا هو ابن الحبيب.
This is my beloved son.
له اسمعوا ما فيش غيره اسمعوا لي هو بس.
Hear him, only him.
هذا هو الابن الوحيد الذي في حضن الآب هو خبر.
This is the only begotten son who's in the bosom of the Father, he said, he declared.
كان لازم يجي في جسد.
He had to come in the flesh.
يبقى إنسان.
To be man.
عشان يصنع المصالحة.
So that he can reconcile us.
بين الله والإنسان.
Reconcile God and man.
لكن آخر حاجة هقولها.
But the last thing I'm going to say.
المسيح جه.
Christ came.
علشان يموت.
To die.
كان ده هدف المجيء.
That was the purpose of the coming in the first place.
علشان يموت على الصليب علشان يدفع ثمن خطيتي وخطيتك.
So that he would die on the cross so that he could pay the price for my sin and your sin.
بيقول الكتاب إذا اشترك الأولاد في اللحم والدم اشترك أيضا هو فيهما لكي يبيد بالموت ذاك الذي له سلطان الموت أي إبليس.
And so he says as he has come in the image of man, he came that he may die and defeat that which has power over death through his death on the cross.
كان لازم يموت.
He had to die.
علشان يدفع الثمن.
So that he can pay the price.
لأن من غير بدون سفك دم لا تحصل مغفرة.
Because without the shedding of blood, there's no forgiveness, right?
ده قانون الله، عدل الله.
That's the law of God.
كان لازم يبقى في سفك دم.
There had to be shedding of blood.
هل ممكن الله كان يموت من غير ما يبقى إنسان ياخد جسد إنسان؟
Can God die without taking the image of man?
No. مستحيل.
Impossible.
لأن الله هو الوحيد.
Because God, He's the only one.
له وحده عدم الموت.
Only He is the one that has the ability to not die.
ما ينفعش. ما يقدرش يموت.
Not possible for Him to die.
كان لازم يجي في صورة إنسان.
He had to come in the image of man.
علشان يموت.
To die.
علشان دم يسيل على الصليب.
So the blood would be shed on the
cross. علشان يكون دم المسيح يسوع دم يسوع المسيح ابنه يطهر من كل خطيه.
Because it says the blood of Jesus Christ his son will cleanse from every sin.
فهمتوا موضوع المجيء ليه؟
Do you understand why he came? Does it make sense?
كان لازم يجي كإنسان.
He had to come as man.
كان لازم علشان يموت.
He had to die.
علشان يسفك دم.
So that the blood would be shed.
علشان يكون لنا خلاص.
So that we would have salvation.
يدعى اسمه يسوع لأنه يخلص شعبه من خطاياهم.
His name shall be called Jesus because he will save his people from their sins.
اسمه يسوع لأنه يخلص شعبه من خطاياهم.
His name is Jesus because he will save his people.
واسمه عمانوئيل الله معنا.
From their sins and his name is also Emmanuel God with us.
هو ده اختصار قصة الميلاد.
See, that's the summary of the story of Christmas.
الله يخلص.
God saves.
والله معنا.
And God with us.
ربنا مش عايزك تبقى عبد.
God doesn't want you to be a slave.
يمكن لغاية دلوقتي انت عبد للخطية.
Maybe until today you're still a slave to sin.
ما زلت بتعبد امور وانت بعيد عن ربنا.
You still worship things as you're far from God.
ربنا حزين عليك.
And God is sad about you.
ربنا جه من السماء واحتفالنا النهاردة بعيد الميلاد هو علشان ربنا عايز يحررك من عبودية الخطية من العبودية اللي انت عايش فيها.
God came from heaven because he wants to free you from the bondage that you're in. He wants to set you free.
ربنا ما خلقنيش وما خلقكش علشان تبقى عبد.
God did not create us to be slaves.
لكن خلقك علشان تبقى محبوب لي علشان يحبك.
He created you so that you'd be beloved to him so he would love you.
وربنا عايز النهاردة يعيد العلاقة من جديد.
And God today wants to restore that relationship again.
عايز يخليك ابن.
He wants to make you a child.
عايز يخليك لكل السلطان الابن.
He wants you to have all the authority of a child.
بيقول الكتاب أعتقد في غلاطية 4
The Bible says
إلى خاصته جاء في يوحنا بيقول إلى خاصته جاء وخاصته لم تقبله.
John says that he came to his people and his people did not accept him.
أما كل الذين قبلوه.
But all who have received him.
لغاية دلوقتي النهاردة بيجي لخاصته يمكن كنيسته.
Until today he comes to his people, maybe his church.
ناس القريبين خاصته.
Those who are near.
ده بيتكلم عن شعب الله زمان إلى خاصته لما جه المسيح جه لشعبه جه لشعب الله اللي هم اليهود.
You know, when Christ came, it says he came for his people, which are the Jews.
ورفضوه.
And they rejected him.
وصلبوه.
And they crucified him.
وطلبوا قالوا باراباس يطلق حر والمسيح يموت يصلب.
And they said set Barabbas free and Christ goes to the cross.
ده شر الإنسان.
That's the evil of man.
ربنا جه مخصوص علشانهم.
God came specifically and especially for them.
إلا خصته جاء.
He came to his people.
خصته لم تقبله.
His people did not.
النهاردة ربنا بيقع على باب قلبك وبيقول لك أنا جيت علشانك أنت.
And today.
علشانك أنت.
God is knocking at your door and says, "I came for you."
هل بتعمل نفس الحكاية زي شعب الله يرفضوه؟
Do you do the same thing that the people of God did, reject him?
لكن الكتاب بيقول أما كل الذين قبلوه.
The Bible says, "And all who have received him."
كل.
All.
مش مهم أنت فين ولا حالتك إيه ولا بتعمل إيه.
Doesn't matter where you're at, what you're doing.
كنت بعيد أو قريب.
Doesn't matter if you're close or far.
أما كل الذين قبلوا أعطاهم سلطانا أن يصيروا أولاد الله.
All who have received him, he has given them authority to be children of God.
نفسك تبقى ابن.
Do you want to be a child of God?
ولا عبد.
Or do you want to be a slave?
في غلاطي 4:4. هختم بالآيتين.
Can I end with Galatians 4:4?
يقول الكتاب لما جاء ملء الزمان.
The Bible says, but when the fullness of the time had come,
أرسل الله ابنه.
God sent forth his son,
مولودا من امراه,
born of a woman,
مولودا تحت الناموس,
born under the law.
ليه؟ ايه السبب؟ علشان يفتدي الذين هم تحت الناموس,
to redeem those who were under the law.
اللي الناس اللي تحت الناموس اللي اجره الخطيه هي موت.
The people who are under the law and the wages of sin is death.
لكن بيقول اما هبه الله فهي حياه ابديه.
The Bible says but the gift of God is eternal life.
قصة الميلاد هي عبارة عن هبة, هبة الله حياة أبدية.
The story of Christmas is about a gift of God, eternal life.
عطية الله للناس.
The gift of God to man.
ليفتدي الذين تحت الناموس.
To redeem those who were under the law.
عشان إيه؟
Why?
عشان نبقى أبناء لننال التبني.
So we be children that we might receive the adoption.
احنا كلنا ما كناش ابناء, احنا كنا بعيدين خالص, كنا الامم ولا اليهود حتى, احنا بعاد, احنا بعاد خالص.
By the way, we were really far, we were not children, we were not even Jews.
لكن لننال التبني, التبني ده عباره عن مش حاجه يعني خدناها باستحقاق, لكن خدناها بالتبني.
And you know, to be adopted is not something that anyone receives based on merit. They receive it because someone adopts them.
لكن هي قصة حب الله للإنسان اللي ما يستحق.
It's a story of God's love for man who doesn't deserve.
ولما تبقوا أبناء.
And when you become a son, a child.
ثم بما أنكم أبناء أرسل الله روح ابنه إلى قلوبكم صارخا يا أبا الآب.
And because you are sons, God has sent forth the Spirit of His Son into your hearts, crying out, Abba, Father.
ما بقيش بعيد عنك.
He's not far from you.
لكن بقي بابا.
But he became father. بقي بابا
اللي تصرخ له لما تكون تعبان.
He became father that you cry to when you are
weary. بقي بابا اللي تصرخ له لما تكون محتاج.
He became father that you cry to when you are in need.
الله بقي بابا ليا.
God became father to me.
وبقي روح الله بيصرخ جوايا.
And the Spirit of God started crying out.
يابا الآب.
Abba, Father.
إيه رأيك النهاردة تقبل, تقبل عطية السماء, تقبل التبني, تقبل روح الله اللي بيصرخ يابا الآب.
What do you think? Would you accept today the story of adoption to be a child, the story of love, the Holy Spirit that you can cry out, Abba, Father?
ولو كنت قبلت.
And if you've received,
اعرف النهاردة إن أنت مش عبد.
You need to know today that you are not a slave.
ما ينفعش تعيش في الخطية وتبقى عبد وأنت ابن.
You can't live in sin and be a slave and you're a child.
تعال النهاردة وقول له يا رب أنا عايز أخذ مكاني عندك, أبقى ابن, أبقى ابن بتمتع بيك يا رب.
Tell him, Lord, I want to take my position with you and be your son and enjoy the freedom.
عدد سبع بيقول إذا لست بعد عبدا.
Verse 7, it says, therefore you are no longer a slave.
اعرف, اعرف مكانتك.
You need to know your position.
اعرف مكانتك إن أنت مش عبد.
You need to know your position that you're not a slave.
بل ابنا.
But son.
ومش ابن بس.
Not just a
لا,
son.
لا, ده ابن وارث.
But you're an heir. You're going to
inherit. فوارثا لله بالمسيح.
You're an heir of God through Christ.
هنورث إيه؟
What are we going to inherit?
ده كل مجد المسيح, كل عظمة المسيح هي ليا.
All the glory and the greatness of Christ is for me.
وقريب جدا هتكون في بيت الآب لو ابن.
And by the way, very soon if you're a child, you're going to be in the Father's house.
مفيش غير أبناء في بيت الآب.
Only the children are found in the Father's
house. عشان كده بيقول بيت الآب.
That's why it's called the Father's house.
مين اللي يقعدوا في البيت الآب؟
Who stays in the Father's house?
الأبناء بس.
Only children.
الأصدقاء بعد ما بيخلصوا يقعدوا, حتى لو كان في حفلة كل واحد يروح بيته, مش كده؟
Now if there's a party, everyone goes home after the party.
في الآخر بتقعد مع أبوك للأسف, يعني قصدي يعني.
Then who you left with? Your father, right? Sadly or good.
في ناس بتضحك وناس مش بتضحك. اوكي ماشي.
Some are smiling, some are not.
لكن في الاخر هو الحال كده, انك بتقعد في البيت لو انت ابن.
Stay in your house if you're a child.
انا بتكلم على الاب السماوي.
I'm talking here about the heavenly father.
في صور كثيره مشوهه للاب الارضي.
There are very many very distorted pictures of the earthly fathers.
لأن الأب الأرضي غير الأب السماوي خالص.
Because the earthly father is very different than the heavenly
father. بعيد خالص عنه.
Not even close.
أنا بتكلم عن الأب السماوي.
I'm talking about the heavenly father.
أنت ابن.
You're a child.
مش للأب الأرضي الضعيف الخاطئ, لكن أنت ابن لله بالمسيح يسوع.
And you are not a child of a weak earthly father, but you're a child of the Father in heaven.
أنت محبوب.
Through Jesus Christ, you're beloved.
أنت غالي.
You're precious.
لست عبدا فيما بعد.
You are no longer a slave.
بل ابنا.
But child.
وارث.
And you're an heir.
اعرف مكانتك.
You need to know your position.
وما تعيش كعبد برا.
And don't live as a slave outside.
زي العبيد.
Like the slaves.
قد ايه الاب يحزن لما يشوف يكون وخصوصا اب لما يكون ملك ويشوف ابنه بيروح مع عيال الشوارع.
And how sad it is for a father to see their child, especially if the father's a king, to see his children playing with.
النهارده بيقول لك رب انت ابن الملك وليك حق انك تبقى ملك.
And so God is saying, you are the child of the king and you have the right
عبداً بل ابناً.
To live like the son of the king. You are not a slave but a son.
نصلي مع بعض.
Let's pray together.
نفس النهارده ربنا يمتعك بفرحة العيد.
I really wish that today God can let you enjoy the joy of the celebration of Christmas.
مش بتكلم على فرحة العالم بالعيد.
Not how the world celebrates Christmas.
لكن عايز النهارده رب فعلا يفرحي يفرحني ويفرحك.
But I really want the Lord today to give you joy.
انك تعرف ربنا هو مين.
To know who God is.
ربنا اللي جه علشان هو بيحبك.
God who came because he loves you.
ربنا جه علشان لا تهلك.
God came so that you do not perish.
ربنا جه علشان تبقى ابن.
God came so that you'd be his child.
علشان يصالحك.
To reconcile you.
تعال النهارده واقبل.
Come today and accept.
تعال اقبل عطية الله ليك.
Come and accept the gift of God for you.
وإن استهزأت.
And if you mock.
ولا رفضت.
Or reject.
أو دست.
Or you step on.
فكم عقابا أشر بيقول الكتاب.
As the Bible says, oh how worse is the punishment.
لمن استهان بدم المسيح.
For those who despise the blood of Christ.
استهان بمحبة المسيح وعطية المسيح.
And despise the love of Christ and the gift of Christ.
ربنا ما جاش عشان يدينك.
God did not come to judge you.
لكن لو رفضت عطية الله.
But if you reject the gift of God.
فكم عقابا أشر يكون لك.
Oh, how worse is the punishment that awaits you.
هذا ربنا عايزك تهرب من الشر.
Today God wants you to run away from the evil.
وتقبل عطية السماء.
And receive the gift of heaven.
تعال النهارده بكل تواضع كده زي ما جم وسجدوا للمسيح.
Come with all humility like they came and worshiped Christ.
اقبل النهارده.
Accept today.
اقبل عطية السماء.
Accept the gift of heaven.
أما كل الذين قبلوا أعطاهم سلطانا.
But all who have received him, he has given them authority.
أن يصيروا أولاد الله.
To be children of God. Father, thank you for your word to us, and we thank you for your gift to us in this time where we remember the birth of Jesus. Thank you that you loved us, that you gave your only begotten Son. That whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And Jesus, we thank you that you were not forced into coming, but that was what was joyous in your sight, and you loved us, and you desired to die for us, and you looked forward to saving us. So we pray that we would have a heart of gratitude to see how amazing this love is that was demonstrated for us. While we were sinners, you died on the cross for us. We pray that we would live a life of gratitude, of humility, of thanksgiving, a life that would reflect that position that you have given us, that you've made us through adoption, made us heirs, that we inherit the Father through you, Jesus. So we pray that we would live as people of the heavenlies, people who have been seated in the heavenlies, and people who have been blessed with every spiritual blessing in the heavenlies. We pray that we would live this, the richness and the joy that you've brought us when you came to earth, when you were born. And we pray for blessing for your servant, that you continue to bless him in everything that you use him in. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank you.